Hi, I would like you to design a stock trading application.
Oh, okay. So you want, so the functional requirement is, okay, so this is the application for the B2B or B2C?
B2C.
B2C.
I mean, do you know about like Robinhood?
Okay, so you want to design something like Robinhood, okay.
But my focus is more mainly on the backend.
I see, okay. So if I talk about the functional requirement, okay, so user should be able to create profile, okay. And users should be able to buy, sell stock. Okay. And when user is buying or selling a stock, will they have an option like a market day, or can they have like an immediate trade?
Yeah, that's fine. We can just consider that, okay, they have all different type of buying and selling options.
Okay.
But apart from that, what else do you think?
Okay, the user can buy and sell, and they have their profile, mm-hmm. and they can, okay, so they can see the performance of their investment. Okay, so the performance of their investment.
Okay.
And users should be, okay, so can they do some planning? Like say, if the price goes to this amount, then buy it, or if it reached to this threshold, then sell it?
No, that's fine. That's fine. But what else other apart from that?
Okay, so user can buy the shares, can sell the shares. They can create the profile. They can see the investment performance.
So user can have a watch list as well, yes? He can put add stocks into a watch list.
User can, you know, add favorite stock. User can set up some notification. Like for example, if Amazon shares goes below 3,000, then you mm-hmm. notify me kind of thing.
Okay.
Okay. User can set up some notification.
So let's focus on these things. So you said once for the number four is that user can add favorite stock. So where he can add a favorite stock, some watch list or something, and how the watch list will be updated.
Okay, so we will have to build some listener, which should be keep pulling the data from the marketplace, like from the stock market. Or maybe okay. some Google Finance or any site where they can see the latest price of the stock.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you want, okay, so how the user, when the user is going to do the trading, are they going to integrate with any broker system?
Yes, you are actually providing a broker system.
So basically,
just like Robinhood is a broker system.
Okay. So then it will have a latest price information. So user has to create some kind of listener. Okay, so what we can do is in the backend, for example, if, so this is my client. Okay, so let's talk about the API. What are the API should be for this one?
Mm-hmm.
So first API will be buy, okay, buy stock.
Okay.
It will take the user token. It will take the symbol which they want to buy, quantity.
Okay.
And sell stock, user token, symbol, quantity, the lot, from which lot they want to sell, if they want to specify the certain lot, or it can be more than one lot. So it will be list of lots. Okay. You will have buy stock, sell stock. User will have the add watch. Watch list, user token symbol, okay. And same, they can also remove from the watch list. So remove from watch list, user token and symbol. And they can, okay, so when they are adding into the watch list, they, okay, so when they add to the watch list, they want to see on the in their dashboard, or do you want to add the notification? So we already have discussed about the notification. So say setup notification and user token symbol and target price.
Okay, so have you used Robinhood application?
I haven't used Robinhood yet.
You have not used. Okay, but usually what it shows is like you can see the prices on a dashboard. So all the stocks.
Oh, okay, so they do not provide the notification service?
I don't know. Yeah, but for this interview, actually, I'm more interested in the watch list thing, that how you will add stocks to a watch list and how you can actually monitor those live updates happening to those stocks.
I see. Okay. So this is the API, and if we want to design the architecture, so it will be something like that. We will have a client. This is my client, and then I will have a server. So this is the internet, and okay, and then we will have a load balancer here. So I will add the load balancer here, or I will just say API gateway that will basically manage everything. So this is my API gateway. Okay, and then I will have. So I will have a bunch of services here. One service will be the watch list service. Then we will have user profile. And we have user profile service. And we have a trading service, which basically take care of the buy and sell.
Okay.
Trading service. We will have the user. And so we will have the watch list service, user profile, trading service, and then we will have the monitoring and analytics. So analytics.
Okay.
Monitoring. Okay. And we will have some data aggregator, so they can see reports, they can run some report and dashboard. So
I think let's focus more on the watch list service first.
Okay. Sure.
And okay. Then we will discuss also the design of trading service. Okay,
sure. So if I talk about the watch list service, I'm going to. And so for the watch list, what user can do, I mean, what we can do here is we will have a bunch of, so we will have a trading, I'm just saying how the data is going to come. So we will have some publisher here. So price publisher. Okay, and that will basically send the data to some message broker. So we will have maybe RabbitMQ we can use, or we can use Kafka. Okay, so this is considered as a message broker.
Okay.
And it will have a topic. So for each symbol, we can have a topic here.
Okay.
And what we can do is it will publish the price.
So let's assume that we have like this one service. Let's just assume it's a like a stock exchange service. Okay. Mm-hmm. And that stock exchange service actually can give you any stock price in real time. Let's suppose right now. Okay.
Okay.
So let's assume. We are not going to discuss right now how that is implemented. You can define whatever the interface it will have. Okay. And based on that, you can actually use that service to actually design your watchlist service.
Okay. So you are going to go with the pull model. So we will be basically calling and getting the price rather than the push model.
I will let you decide. What do you think?
Okay. Because if we have to call the stock exchange REST API, then it's a pull model, right? So we have to call the REST API every time we want to see the new price.
Okay.
Okay. And in the push model, whenever the price is changed, the stock service will just send the price informations to some message broker. And then each watch, so I will have a watch list service. So what it will do is all the symbols which every user is interested in. So it will basically read for that symbols and it do the fan out. So fan out will have like each user ID and the symbol. And it basically store the updated price in the cache. So when the user will log in, they can see the latest price in their dashboard.
Okay.
From the cache.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. So let's go with this model. So this is the stock exchange. NYSE service. And it pushes the stock price whenever it changes. And then we will have a bunch of worker thread here, which will basically, so this is my worker.
Okay.
Okay. Worker thread. And what it do is, this worker thread will, okay, so now the question is how we are going to update to the each user, because it will have only the simple price.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to maintain somewhere in the dictionary. So we will have some distributed cache where we will have a dictionary which has the symbol as a key and all the user ID as a collection of the user ID as a value.
Okay.
So whoever is interested for any symbol, they just add, it will add that user ID in that dictionary.
Okay.
So this worker, what it will do is whenever it get the price of a symbol, it will send this information to another message broker. So the other message broker will have information, something like this. So this message broker will have, so this will have a bunch of symbol, user ID, current price. Okay, so it will basically fan out the message in this order.
Okay.
Into the, in this message broker. And then we will have another worker, which is sitting here. So here we will have like a bunch of worker. All they do is they will update the user profile, like where we have the user data, it will update the.
Why do they need to update the user profile?
Not the user profile, but where the user has all their dashboard information. Like we will have the user dashboard, the data aggregator, you can call it a data aggregator, or you can call the user
isn't dashboard. Isn't it the watchlist service?
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, yeah, that's a good idea. So basically, user can call the watchlist service. Okay. So it will update in the watchlist service. So watchlist service will have multiple form of the data. So one form of the data will be this one. So we will have like multiple collections, multiple dictionary. So one dictionary will be key is symbol.
Okay.
And the value is list of user ID. This dictionary will be used by this worker. Okay.
So let me give you an example. So how many do you think Robinhood application has users?
They may have millions of users.
Millions of users. Okay. And I think most of them may have Apple stock, for example, in their watch list.
Oh, okay. Yes. Ah, I see. So then I think it does not need to maintain this list. What it will do is it will have a symbol and the decimal, which is the latest price.
Okay.
Okay. So symbol and latest price.
Okay.
Okay. And
so these workers, they are just going and updating this price. So where this information, this data structure is stored? It's an in-memory data structure. It's in
store. Okay. So this will, we will have a global cache.
Okay.
Okay. Because we may have like a multiple, because this watch list will not be able to fulfill all the requirement in single node. So we will have like a multiple nodes. Mm-hmm. And also, I think the total symbol is like 350,000 or maybe like a 500,000 symbols we may have. So that can fit easily in one machine, but we can have replicated so that we can, you know, distribute the load. And so this is the information about the latest symbol, but we also need to maintain user and their symbol, right? So the user profile where it has, it can also maintain a list of the user ID and the collection of the symbol they are interested in.
Okay, so you are storing that information in the user profile service, not in the watchlist service.
Because...
I didn't get it. Like, what's the purpose of the watchlist service then?
Watchlist service will only watch the latest price for that symbol. But if we want to maintain, then we have to maintain another collection here, which is the user ID and the list of symbol, right?
Okay.
Okay. So I think we can go with this route also, because then the watchlist service does not need to talk to the user profile. So the client can directly send a request to the watchlist, and watchlist know all the symbols they are registered for, and it will get the latest price for each symbol, and it will just return the data back to the client.
Okay. But right now,